The PowerPoint Hide Slide option customizes your presentation and adds flexibility so you can reduce the length and timing of a presentation without creating a new one, add slides to back up data and answer audience questions, or provide additional information when time allows. Hi, I'm Dawn Bjork, the software pro. I'm also a Microsoft certified trainer and a certified PowerPoint specialist. In this training, we'll look at how to easily hide slides while still having the option to move to and even print hidden slides. To hide a slide in PowerPoint, switch to either the normal view or the slide sorter view. Next, do one of the following to hide or unhide a slide. Right-click on the slide you want to hide and then left-click on Hide Slide. Or select the Slideshow tab in the PowerPoint ribbon. And here we have Hide Slide. So I'll move to another slide that I'd like to hide or have available, but I don't want to use it right now. Perhaps this is a topic that I may not have time to discuss. And so once again, with this selected, I'll choose a Slideshow ribbon and simply select Hide Slide. We can recognize a hidden slide because the number has a diagonal line across it. Now, depending upon the view, the slide number appears either next to or below the slide you have hidden. Let's look at this from the slide sorter view. So from the slide sorter view, we can see which slides are hidden simply by looking for that slash or diagonal line through the slide number, plus the hidden slides are faded or muted. And so here are a few of my hidden slides. I have a few others. Once again, this is something I could access if I have questions or if I have time. And at the end of the presentation, I also have a section slide that I might use if this is a longer presentation. And so this is another strategy as well. That is, know first of all that the Microsoft PowerPoint Hide Slide feature can be switched on and off for any slide in a presentation. And when you hide a slide, it remains in the presentation file and sequence, even though it's hidden when you run the presentation as a slideshow. Instead of hiding slides, some presenters prefer to just move unused slides to the end of their presentation so they can maintain a logical sequence within their core presentation, because the slide numbers are still there, but those slides will be skipped when the slideshow is run. So here we have a hidden slide. It's slide number 6. And you'll see the slides before it and after it. Now, when I'm running this presentation, one way to navigate to it, even to a hidden slide, is that when the slideshow is running, we simply type in the slide number and then hit enter. In this case, that's slide number 6. Let's see how that works. And whether it's in sequence or at any time that I want to move to it, the slide number 6 is not going to display. So here's slide number 5. And if I continue, then I would be looking at then the agenda that would come up. But what if I want to display that? Well, I'll simply type in 6 and hit enter. And there's my slide. One of the things that will help you with this is, rather than trying to memorize those numbers because your presentation might evolve, is instead make sure that you have a printed handout of those slides. So here's my slide handout view, and we'll see that we have the slide numbers that are available. You could also create your own cheat sheet with the slide numbers or the titles and the numbers in case you wanted to move to them, but this becomes an easy reference. The intention is that you're not sharing it with your audience. You're using it as a reference if you want to bring up a chart that shows more detail about the particular topic or has some additional statistics or other resources on your presentation topic. Another technique to move to a hidden slide is to right-click on any slide while you're delivering your slideshow. And from here, then you can say see all slides. And then you'll see all the slides, including the hidden ones. And from here, we can navigate to any slide we want to. Now I'll simply escape out of that, but I'm still in my slideshow. Another way to do that while we're running the presentation is to press Control S. Now this is a little bit different display. keep in mind Control S is the shortcut for saving your presentation. Now you can then simply choose which slides you want to move to, and you'll see the hidden slides have the parentheses around the slide number. So there's some different strategies here in terms of how you want to work with it. And if I wanted to move to this slide, I could simply choose Go To. It's good to keep in mind that under most presentation setups, the audience will also see the slide list from the menu. When you're running your presentation from the presenter view, you have one other option to be able to easily move to hidden slides or to other slides that you'd like to navigate to. And this is the option See All Slides. Now, from the presenter view, one of the advantages here is that your audience will not see this navigation. And so notice how easy it is here then to move to any of those hidden slides. As well, you can move to other slides. And that can be helpful when you're in a Q&A session with your audience and perhaps they want to go back to something that you had shared in your content. And so from here, we can see once again our hidden slides are grayed out and we see that slash through the number, but can easily move to this as part of my presentation, whether or not it's hidden. And so that's a bonus option for you if you're under the presenter view. Otherwise, with those other techniques, your audience will see those actions being displayed on the screen in front of them. How can you seamlessly move to those hidden slides when you want to? And so this is definitely something that you want to practice as part of your presentation practice. When you print a presentation, you have the option to decide whether or not you will actually print the hidden slides. You can check this preference here. Under Print All Slides, look at the bottom here, Print Hidden Slides. Now I'm going to uncheck that. And notice what happens. I'll move to that page where we had those hidden slides. So the numbering doesn't change, which is good, but then those slides, slide number 12 and 13, are no longer displayed in this handout. So this is a good option if you are, in fact, printing out handouts or resources for your audience, even if you're sending it to a PDF. So it's easy to be able to control exactly how you work with hidden slides in PowerPoint. How will you use the hidden slides feature to build in more flexibility and grab control of your PowerPoint presentations? Now you've seen how to save time and effort in PowerPoint by hiding slides in a presentation. For more tips on being productive with PowerPoint, head to thesoftwarepro.com/PowerPoint. If this training was helpful, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to this channel. This is Dawn Bjork, the Software Pro. Thanks for watching.